Good morning, students. Today we will discuss the topic basics of energy and its various form from the subject energy conservation and auditing. So now, what is the energy? First of all, energy is a ability to do work, and energy can neither be created and nor be destroyed. It transfer from one form to another form. The various form of energy, like as two type of energy, which is store energy or working energy. In the store energy, which is potential energy, in the potential energy, it exists in various form, like as chemical energy, nuclear energy, mechanical energy, and gravitational energy. And in the kinetic energy, it exists in the various form, like as radial energy, radiant energy, thermal energy, motion energy, sound energy, electrical energy. So in the energy which is required, the basic tariffs, it means electricity tariff by the utility or distribution center. Different type of tariff are there, which is simple tariff, flat rate tariff, block rate tariff, two-part tariff, maximum demand tariff, power factor tariff. In the simple tariff, the customer pay the money to using some amount of power. In the flat rate tariff, which is KVA tariff, which is used by the companies, and block rate tariff, which is fixed in the particular time periods, and two-part tariff, which is flat rate tariff or break rate tariff, maximum demand tariff, which is like as peak power tariff, and also power factor tariff, and three-part tariff, which is used by the big consumer or industrial consumer. And now the next topic is calculation of electric bill for a company. So the electric bill for a company, for power supplying company, charges for industrial customer not only based on amount of energy used in kilowatt hour, but in also peak demand or maximum demand in KVA in each of the month. So now the next topic is contract demand. Contract demand is the amount of electric power that a customer demand from utility in a specified interval. It means the contract demand is used in KVA or kilowatt. In the maximum demand time period or interval demand is a 15 minute for the national level, but in the local level it is used as the 30 minute interval or 15 to 60 minute interval, 15 minute, 30 minute or 60 minute at different distribution centers. So the maximum demand is the highest average KVA recorded during any one interval within the month. That is called maximum demand. And prediction of load. While considering the method of load prediction, some of the term used in connection with power supply must be appreciated. It means prediction load, like as connected load, demand factor, and load factor. And connected load, it is the name plate rating. It means kilowatt rating or KV rating of the apparatus installed on a customer premises. And demand factor, it is the ratio of maximum demand to connected load. And next, now the load factor, it is the ratio of average load to maximum load. So the load factor is also defined as the ratio of energy consumed during a given period or to the energy which would have been used if the maximum load had been maintained throughout the period. For example, the load factor for a 24 hour will be given as energy consumed during 24 hour divided by maximum demand recorded in 24 hours. So now the next topic is load management and maximum demand control. So what do you understand by load management and maximum demand control? So load management, it means saving the energy from a particular company, particular home, particular business, etc., etc. And maximum demand control, it means demand utilization is going to down, and maximum demand at the time period or particular time, which is reduced by the management of load. So the first topic is need for electrical load management. In the electrical load management, which is used in various type of motors in the industry and home appliances, agriculture, industrial, residential, etc. So in the perspective, the growth of electricity use and diversity of end use segment in time of use had led to shortfall in capacity to meet demands. And as capacity addition is costly and only a long time prospect, better load management at user end help to minimize peak demand on the utility infrastructure, as well as better utilization of power plant capacities. So the utility like state electricity board, central electricity board, and also private sector use power tariff structure to influence end user in better load management through measure like time of use tariff, etc. In penalty on exceeding allowing maximum demand night tariff occasional, light tariff concessional. So the load management is a powerful mean of energy improvement both for end user as well as utility. It means the efficiency or improvement or efficiency of the system both side in distribution center or generation center is improved by the load management is maintained throughout the period of time, throughout the use of power. So the step by step approach for the maximum demand control is following point are the maximum demand control, such as load curve generation, rescheduling of load, storage of products, shedding of non-essential load, operation of captive generation and diesel generation set, reactive power compensation. In this lecture, we have discussed about the load management and maximum demand control. So thank you for having patience, and in the next lecture, we have discussed about the other topic related to the energy conservation and auditing.